Hello guys, this is Vamshi, and in this video we are going to discuss the water saving efficiency and yield increase in different crops for sprinkler irrigation and drip irrigation. So first of all, we will look through the sprinkler irrigation. So in sprinkler irrigation, use of sprinklers for different crops. In cereals, sprinklers were used for maize, sorghum, wheat and zoar. For flowers, carnation, jasmine and marigold. And oil seed, groundnut, mustard and sunflower. Vegetables, onion, potato, radish and carrot. For fodders, asparagus, pastures, pulses. For pulses, it is gram, pigeon pea, beans. For plantation, coffee, rubber, tamarind, fiber, cotton, sesame. For spices, it's cardamom is used. Now we'll look at the response of different crops to sprinkler irrigation. When compared to surface irrigation or flood irrigation. In Bajra, 56% of water is saved and 19% of yield is increased through sprinkler irrigation. In barley, 56% is water saved and yield increased is 16%. In Bendi, it is 28% water is saved and 23% yield is increased. In cabbage, it is 40 and 3. In cauliflower, water saving is 35, yield increased is 12. In chilies, water saved is 33 and yield increased is 24. In cotton, water saving is 36 and yield increased is 50. Cowpea, it's 19 and 3. In fenugreek, it's 29 and 25. In garlic, it's water saved is 28% and yield increased is 6%. In gram, water saved is 69% and yield increased is 57%. I think it is the highest yield efficiency after cotton. In groundnut, the water saved is 20 and the yield increased is 40. In jowar, it's 55 and 34. In lucerne, it's 16 and 27. In maize, it is 41 and 36. In onion, it is 33 and 23. In potato, it's 46 and 4. In sunflower, it is 33 and yield increase is 20%. Wheat, water saved is 35% and the yield increase is 24%. So guys, I'll suggest you that you don't need to remember all these things. You just pick up, there are nearly about 20 to 25 crops here. So you need to remember 10 most important crops, just like bajra, cauliflower, chilies, cotton, gram, groundnut, maize, onion, sunflower, potato and wheat. And jowar. These were most important crops in which the sprinkler irrigation efficiencies need to be remembered. So now we'll look after the benefits of drip irrigation over surface irrigation. We have completed the sprinkler irrigation benefits. Now we are here at the benefits of drip irrigation over surface irrigation. In the crops mango, it is 80% yield increase and water saved is 34.8. In banana, the yield increase is 52.0 and water saving is 45.0. In grapevine, it is 23.0 yield increase and 48% of water saving. In pomegranate, the yield increase is 98% and water saving is 45%. I think this is the highest, so it is most important thing to be remembered. In tomato, it's 50% yield increase and 39% water saving. In watermelon, it is 88% yield increase and 36% water saving. In banana, grapevine, pomegranate and watermelon, which have been highlighted here, need to be remembered for examination point of view. And then after, in vegetables, it's lady's finger, 16% yield increase and water saving is 40%. In brinjal, it's 14 and 53. In chilies, it's 44 and 62. In papaya, it's 75 and 68. crop in crops like sugarcane, its yield increase is 133.3%. It is highest, and it need to be underlined and remembered. Water saving is 49.3. In cotton, it is 88.0, and water saving is 46.6. In onion, 53.8 and 46.1. In potato, it's 79.5, and water saving percentage is 54.41. So, friends, I would like to tell you that. These type of questions were asked in competitive exams. These types of questions were asked in tricky way, so you will get confused. The question will be easy if you focus on the question. Read the question carefully, and you have concept in your mind. There is nothing difficult to answer. So we can look after. So on the screen you can see the irrigation efficient on farm irrigation efficiency of different irrigation methods. The graph is given where, so we can see here. The first one, in the y-axis we have given the efficiency percentage. In x-axis, the different types of irrigation methods were given. In y-axis, for flood irrigation, we can see the field on-farm efficiency is very low. It's 30% to 60%. And level furrow irrigation, it's 50% to 70%. In sprinkler, it is 70% to 85%. In central pivot, it is 70% to 90%. In drip irrigation, it's 90% to 95%. So the major irrigations used in India were flood, level furrow, sprinkler, and drip. This central pivot system is not much used. So guys, this is it. So if you like my work and video, please like, share, and subscribe the channel. Thank you.